So how do you make your resume stand out from the hundreds or perhaps thousands of other people competing for a job? Let's talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And the question was, how do you make your resume stand out of the crowd? Because one of the things you'll find that you'll come across when you're actually looking for a job and applying for jobs is there's lots of other people obviously doing the same thing. And if you think about it from the other perspective, someone who's looking to hire someone, they've got to read through these resumes. So one of the key things is to try and make yourself stand out. So how do you actually make yourself stand out? Well, firstly, try not to do an obvious thing, which I've seen a lot of programmers do, and that's just grab a template off the internet and just change that slightly, you know, update your own personal details and a few other things about any experience or what you've studied, and then send it through. The danger with that is if it looks very similar to lots of other people's resumes, chances are you're not going to stand out. Well, in fact, you're not going to stand out, are you? Because how are you going to stand out unless someone is actually reading through every resume in detail? And I'm going to give you a tip right here now about how your resume is viewed by a prospective employer. It's called scanning. And they'll grab your resume, they'll have a quick look through, and they're looking for keywords and something that grabs their attention. If they don't find that, and in their opinion, after that quick scan, you're very similar to a lot of other people who have actually applied, you'll either get binned or you won't be taken out of the poll. And if you're not taken out of the poll, chances are it's going to be very hard to stand out and to actually get an interview. So you really do need to make yourself stand out. So first things first, make sure you don't copy other templates. You know, there's templates out there that you can download. Just do a search for, you know, resume template. You'll find hundreds of Microsoft Word documents or whatever. So don't do that, number one. But secondly, try and focus on what you want the prospective employer to see. I mean, does he really care that you've had three jobs that aren't programming related? Chances are he probably isn't interested in that. He wants to know, he or she wants to know whether you are a good match for their organization. So therefore, try and put that information up front. So focus on what you think, you know, the reasons that you think you're a good match for this organization. Are you certified? Have you done some certifications? Have you completed some computing courses? Have you looked at GitHub and done some, you know, perhaps found a project and contributed to that project? That should be something you're focusing on, number one. Talk about the technologies that you've got experience with. And these are the types of things that someone scanning through a resume will look at, and hopefully that'll stand out to them and they can grab it, and then at least you'll warrant further attention. So make sure you try and really, really sell yourself, but focus it again. It's not about you. This is really important. When you're writing a resume, it's not about you. It's about the employer. So write your resume from the employee's perspective. Just really the easiest way to do it, this is what I used to do when I used to apply for jobs. I used to try and imagine myself as the employer reading my resume. And how, you know, what am I getting out of this resume? What's standing out for me? And, you know, give me a reason, in other words, is what I'm saying when I'm scanning through that resume to actually want to speak to you. So focus on that. Focus on giving the information that the employer needs. And another thing you can do is try not to make it like a 12-page or 15-page resume. I've seen huge resumes. One or two pages is probably the maximum you need. Now, depending on the job, if you're obviously going for a job that requires all sorts of extensive experience, and perhaps you need to pad it out, but I would actually stick to a pretty basic resume. And the other thing that I would recommend you do is to tailor the resume for the application, for the position you're actually applying for. Now, as an example of that, let's just say you're applying for three jobs. One job is a Java developer, one's a C-sharp developer, and the third one says C++ development position. So three different languages, and you happen to know these languages. So the best way to do that is not to give them a cookie-cutter generic template, but rather to give them a resume, I almost said template, but a resume that is actually really set up for that particular language. So, you know, if you're going for a Java position, a Java entry-level position or whatever it is, Java, the word Java should be heavily used at the top of the resume and really, really emphasized. So it should be really clear to the person who's reading your resume that you know Java. So, you know, that's really, really the tip here is what I'm trying to say. Even though it takes a lot of extra work, or can be potentially a lot of extra work from your perspective, if you're customizing your resume to the position, then that's going to give you a greater likelihood at least of getting to the next stage where you can present your case, so to speak, at an interview. So try customizing your resume to fit the position that you're actually applying for. So all of these things are really trying to just get you to the next step. So keep in mind that the purpose of a resume isn't to get you the job. The purpose of a resume is to get that interview. Once you get to the interview, then there's other techniques you need to start looking at to present well in an interview. So if you focus on that and think like the one task of your resume is just to get to that interview, to get noticed, to get someone to take an interest in you, you're halfway there. And the greatest way of looking at this, the easiest way to maximize your chances is just to think of this from the employer's perspective. Once you've finished your resume that you're, before you go to send it out, pretend you're the employer reading through your resume. Is it an enticing read? Will they be interested in working with you or contacting you once they've read the resume? So good luck with it. Focus on that, and that'll greatly increase your chances of getting that interview, because I can tell you right now, having read through literally thousands of resumes over the years, most people going for applying for a job don't do this. So that's a secret tip there. Good luck with it, and I'll see you in the next video. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.